Independent candidate Nick Perlas, who may be the greenest of all the presidential bets based on his credentials as an environmentalist, but he's also green in other ways. This is his first run for public office. Good morning and welcome to Head Start, sir.
Yes, good morning, Karen. Thanks for having me here this morning.
You're welcome. Actually, we've been wanting to have you. So I'm just curious, are you going to have a Nick Perlas babe?
I haven't thought of that. But there's a lot of young women supporting the candidacy. Yeah.
Okay, so what do I call you? Nicanor, Nick?
Just Nick, yeah.
Or Richard Gere, could be, or here. I mean, why not?
The pepper, salt and pepper here.
So yes. Nick, yeah. Let's start with Nick. Okay. Now, how do you feel about the surveys? I mean, Gilbert Yodor has already spoken out after holding his tongue for a long time.
Right. I think surveys have a function. As a scientist, I can understand the statistical methodology behind it. But the way it's implemented is highly problematic, and in fact, we've experienced cheating on the field with the surveys. That's why I also don't believe surveys. I think it's overdone, and it's also coming out too frequently. It's no longer just for information, but mind conditioning. It's actually a form of mind manipulation.
Okay, ideally, how should surveys be conducted, and how often?
I think the original plan of conducting it every month, just to get a sense of the standing of candidates. And of course, methodologically, the people on top may be honest, but the people on the field may be receiving some payments.
Oh, is that right?
Yes, but also the survey companies have a short list and a long list. The long list has all the names, and I think they do that less often than the short list, which comes out very often, and the shortlists are for those that pay for the services of the survey.
Are you included in the shortlist?
No.
You're never there?
No, because I don't pay for the subscription fees of the survey company.
So that would mean it's a bit inaccurate if there are surveys that come out and you're not on the list and you're running.
Yes, exactly. So the names of those who have a subscription are on the list, and then maybe there's others.
Yes.
So they will have to, it's really unfair in that sense.
No, and what I noticed is candidates now know when it's survey week. That's what shocks me. Like when I talk to candidates, they're like this.
Yeah.
Karen, actually, it's survey week. So exposés come out, tinitira isang kandidato, pluses for one candidate because they're aware.
Exactly. And not only that, Karen, we've heard the news that if they know that the survey is coming out in this area, then they load campaign materials, campaigning in that area, so that they'll come out in the sample. So this is the way you can bias a relatively neutral scientific technique by front-loading it.
Okay.
Yes.
Now, Nicanor Perlas is relatively, in the beginning, an unknown name. Di naman kayo artista. You were never in public office.
Yes.
And at one point, you were even disqualified by the COMELEC. They called you a nuisance candidate.
Exactly. Yeah.
And it was the Supreme Court, right, that said you could run?
No, COMELEC itself.
COMELEC itself.
They reversed.
Overturned.
Their own ruling. Yeah.
So I want to ask you, what made Nicanor Perlas, what clicked? And you said you woke up and said, I am going to run for the presidency.
Right. It was, Karen, I can really vividly remember it. It was September 24, 2008.
Okay.
I was in an airplane in a flight towards Europe, and then I was taking a look at those candidates who had already declared their intention, and I said none of these people who come mostly from traditional political background are going to change this country.
Okay.
People are really wanting some really very different kinds of changes happening to the Philippines.
Yes.
But we cannot rely on the same traditional politicians that created the problem in the first place. That's what got me to say, I'm running because I don't want a further deterioration of the Philippines, especially under this administration.
Now, professionally, you're an agriculturist, but what is it in Nicanor Perlas' profile that makes us trust you to manage the country?
Yes. In fact, I'm really glad you asked it, Karen, because people who don't know my background think I'm ignorant of government processes.
Yes. Or they think you're a teacher.
Yeah.
I've
been a consultant to government for over 20 years.
All right.
At the level of the president, the cabinet, and then also at the Senate, the House of Representatives, governors, mayors, from the outside.
Okay.
I've changed the destiny and lives of millions of Filipinos from the outside. Like, for example, banning, stopping the program of Marcos for 12 nuclear power plants.
That was you.
Yes, our movement in the Bataan Nuclear Power Plant.
Okay.
We banned 32 pesticide formulations of a corrupt Department of Agriculture agency. By the way, during the time of Corazon Aquino,
yeah,
there was corruption there.
Oh, okay.
And then, of course, changing the trade liberalization agreement in APEC,
yes,
which would have damaged 3 million rice farmers. I've done a lot of things that have large-scale impact.
Mm-mm.
And in fact, a lot of observers, including political analysts and columnists, are saying that I'm the most qualified presidential candidate if people took a look at the track record.
Yes. Would you consider yourself a scientist?
Yes, definitely. I have a very strong training in science. And I've continued to read a lot on science even after school.
Okay. Now, the question is, I agree that you may be highly qualified, but are you prepared?
Absolutely. You know, the example like corruption, people are saying it's difficult to deal with corruption. But if the top is honest, it's so easy to deal with corruption. The office of the president can appoint 10,000 officials.
So 14,000, actually. But go ahead. Yeah.
Yeah. No, she's appointed 14. But the limit is 10.
Is that right? Okay.
Yes,
okay. Go ahead. Yeah.
I asked this one.
All right. Go ahead. Yeah.
But for example, they say it's difficult to get rid of corruption in the Bureau of Customs and BAR. But in my campaign, I've been saying that I can get rid of corruption there in 100 days.
Mm-mm.
So it's really possible if there's a determination and a will.
All right.
And I'm the only presidential candidate who's going to create an office of civil society. Cabinet position to engage millions of citizens in the process of governance.
Now, when you say civil society, some people actually
don't understand the term.
Well, civil society, you tie up or you associate with having President Arroyo in office in the year 2000. So when you say civil society, it's a certain group of people. In my mind.
Yes. That has been one interpretation. I would say a very... restricted interpretation. Civil society basically is are all the cultural groups that are non-profit, non-government, trying to who have causes.
Mm-mm.
So the church is part of civil society. Media, those that are not controlled by business are part of civil society.
But definitely not just the elite. Not the elite or the upper middle class. They are not civil society, based on your definition.
They can have their non-profit associations, like their foundations. But, for example, Fisher Folks, farmers' organizations, which are called people's organizations, they're part of civil society.
Ideally.
But they are often misused by government, especially in NAPSI. National Anti-Poverty Commission, plus the NCIP, and stuff like this.
Now, I want to ask you, when I asked about preparation, how prepared are you? It's not about you personally, but your machinery.
Yeah.
I know that you are running with a budget of 4 million pesos, is that right?
Yes.
Is that what you've spent so far?
We've spent maybe 3.5 million.
For the presidential campaign?
Yes.
Oh my God. Is this your own money?
About close to 2 million is my own fund, are my own funds.
Okay.
The rest are donated by individuals. Yeah.
So, all right. You've spent 3.5 million pesos for the presidential campaign over others who are spending billions in advertising.
Right. Yes.
And how do you expect, number one, for your votes to be delivered and for your votes to be counted?
In terms of people voting for me, we have four strategies of converting our qualifications into a vote. Of course, one is media, the conventional media. 2010 elections is unusual because mainstream media is taking a very deep interest in it and therefore are covering the presidential candidates.
Yes.
That's why I didn't feel the need to do a lot of advertising or zero advertising in
this
case.
You were always in the debates, definitely.
Yes, I was always in the debates, the fora, and so on. That's one. And then the internet. 24 million people are in the internet.
Mm-mm.
Maybe
are they all voters?
Half are voters. But they can also influence the non-voters can influence the voters. I have a very strong presence in the internet.
Oh, you do?
Yes.
Okay.
If you Google my name, you'll get close to a million.
Is that really?
Yes, it's one of the highest among the presidential candidates.
Oh, good for you.